Hey everyone, it's Beltsummer 5196, and we are here today on Anime Wednesday with Seduce Me. Now, I ran a Twitter poll. This is the second game for today's Anime Wednesday, because between this game and Yonder Simulator, it was a tie at 47% for both. So when I saw this game, I was like, okay, well, it looks like there's a lot of good visual novels in the anime sector, so I decided to give it a shot. So let's get in. I think it's like a simulation too. Let's just see. Let's get into it. Okay.
Why, hello.
Oh.
My, aren't you a gorgeous sight?
Oh, thank you.
Can I be honored enough to know your name?
Sure.
A lovely name for a lovely person like you. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Eric, do your job.
Eric.
Very well.
Okay.
This game was produced by Seraphim Entertainment under the direction of Michaela Laws and is powered by Renpy Visual Novel Engine. We truly hope you'll enjoy this story. I know I'll enjoy it, since you'll be in it.
Okay.
Eric.
Okay, Eric.
Fine, fine. Farewell, my sweet.
All right. Somewhere. What the fuck am I?
Come on! Is that all you got?
Oh shit, who are you fighting?
Wanna try me, asshole?
Oh shit! What the fuck is going on?
Crap! Missed!
Let's retreat for now!
Oh my god.
No kidding! Let's get out of here!
That's right! You better run, you stupid punks! Stay out of our territory!
Oh, trespassers. Call it fate or call it coincidence, that one moment of violence started a chain of events I will never forget.
This formula, created in the 70s, is one of the most important in the field of financial theory. It is used to calculate the price of European-style options and is widely used by option marketers, though there are some discrepancies that are now corrected with the modern viewpoint.
Okay. Oh, that's me? Rain. It's been a long time since we've gotten rain around here. But it is the season for rainy weather, so it's not exactly that surprising. Personally, I love the sound of it. The way the raindrops fell, like the soft tapping of fingers. Oh my god, there's a lot of reading in this. It's a visual novel. Okay, it was so soothing. Even looking at the droplets hit the glass of the window was strangely calming. For this reason, I felt lucky for having a seat next to the window. Oh, crap. I felt lucky for having a seat next to the window, though I didn't spend more time staring outside than I did paying attention in class. The lectures in class were pretty boring. Mrs. Phillips' voice wasn't so powerful. Shit. Mrs. Phillips' voice wasn't so porific. So porific? But I wasn't interested in what she was saying. And since it was the period right before lunch, all I could think about was doing other things in my free time. Honestly, I didn't really care much for economics. Sure, I had good grades in this class, but it was only because I read the textbook and did my assignments as I had to. I was only taking this class because it was mandatory. If it were up to me, I would probably have taken another course. That is true. So boring. Luckily, it was my senior year, so after this semester, it would mean the end of high school courses forever. Thank God for that. I hear ya. I didn't hate high school. It was just kind of mundane how the days drifted on and on as if there were no end to it. Wait till you get to the real world. Shit. The only thing I really enjoyed about going to school was meeting my friends and hanging out with them, but that was kind of it. Again, wait till you get to the fucking real world. In short, I was done with high school. The start of second semester brought a note of finality to it. I had already applied to many universities the semester prior, and I was expecting reply sometime in the next few months. It seemed like the start of something new, something that would change. That is, if things could change. I stared at the faint outline of raindrops in the distance. For now, I was stuck in class. In this class.
Miss Anderson.
Is that me? Sure. Miss Phillips' raised voice interrupted my train of thought. Just when I was thinking about class, I quickly turned my head to face the teacher. Hopefully she didn't pick me just because she noticed that I was spacing out. What do you want?
Would you care to name the equation I set up on the blackboard?
Oh, I think I read about that in the textbook last night. It should be the Black-Scholes model formula.
Very good as always, Miss Anderson.
Thank you, bitch. Now go away. Anderson, it followed me wherever I went. Most people didn't really know me by my first name, rather than my surname. No doubt, since the surname was a trademark of the internationally famous and philanthropic Anderson Family Toys, and because the founder was my own grandfather. Suzu, one of my best friends, turned around and proudly gave me a punch to the shoulder. Bitch, get your hands off me.
Kick ass, girl.
Oh, that's my boo! From beside me, I heard Naomi, another one of my best friends, clearing her throat in obvious disapproval of Suzu's choice of words. Oh, God, she's a stick in the mud. Oh, God,
She
and she's
means
wearing a
good
bow.
job, Miss Capini. I care to tell me who the creators of this formula were? Some guys named Black and Scholes. Fisher Black and Myron Scholes.
Whatever, goody two shoes.
Very good, Miss Patterson. Show off.
Exactly.
Better study next time, Suzu. Be like us and study once in a while.
Fuck that shit. Suzu's my boo. Suzu rolled her eyes and slouched into her chair as Naomi gave her a small smirk. She always pouted when Naomi showed her up. Naomi's a fucking bitch. How am I friends with her? Get the fuck out of
That's
here.
the end of today's lecture. Now, let's separate into groups and work on your projects. Remember, everything is due on Monday. Go ahead now.
Okay, Monday. Before I knew it, Suzu and No Naomi had scooted their desk to align with mine, and we turned into the Three Musketeers. Whenever the teacher let the students decide on groups, we always grouped together in our little trio. It was a sheer stroke of luck that we all managed to be in the same class, so we had to at least take the opportunity and stick together as much as we could. Besides, we were most comfortable around each other than, say, compared to being around any other classmate. It just made sense for us to put our heads together for any kind of project. I took out the poster we were working on and rolled it up onto the three desks. We were pretty much finished with fulfilling most of the guidelines for the project, though we did still have to add a few finishing touches here and there. After working on making the poster a bit prettier, we sat back and inspected our work to see what we still had to do. Naomi, as usual, was the first to look for any issues. She lightly tapped a pencil against her chin, staring intently at the project.
All right, so let's see. We finished the budgeting section, the building leasing, and the cost for labor. What else do we need?
Suzu straightened up to look at the poster and stroked her chin. After a few seconds, her face brightened and she spoke up.
How about a company name?
Did we really skip over that?
That's like one of the first things you do.
Of course we did. You always go straight into the logical statistics and stuff that you completely skip over the fact. We need a name for our project.
At least we caught it this time. What do we name it?
This time.
Not sure. What do you think?
Bitch, you can't say my name is Summer. Shit. It always came down to me. Whenever there was something to be named or titled, I was the master and ending decision, even when I didn't want it to be. Want to
I
be
like
it.
Trinity Corporations.
That is way too predictable. How about the Dragon Company?
No.
What do dragons have to do with our project?
What? It's a totally unpredictable name. It's hot.
Okay.
But our company sells bubble gum.
Sells bubble gum? Ugh.
Who said we can't produce spicy bubble gum?
Ugh. What do you think? What do you think?
Oh God, now I have to choose between? Both of them looked at me expectantly, even though I wasn't sure myself. I didn't really want to choose sides, but if it were up to me, I would say, fuck, I do have to choose? Guess what, bitch? You're gonna be mad at me.
Booyah! Dragon Company in it!
Yes, it is,
All
bitch.
right, now that we've decided on a name, now what?
As we entered our name game, a giggle scrambled my thoughts. Who the fuck was that, huh? Who? Yeah, exactly. That's what I was like. Who the fuck is that?
Ignore it. It's just Lisette.
Oh, Lisette. I looked over my shoulder to see her laughing with her circle of friends, mostly comprised of. of friends, mostly comprised of popular people that were practically friends with everyone in the school. And as a result, everyone in the school knew them. In the center of it all was Lizette White. She sat with a posture that indicated she was still working, but that she also was ready to casually chat about her day. She had an endearing balance of charismatic and awkward, which was readily apparent when she first talked to someone. It was easy to make her smile and laugh, and she was quite the comedian as well. Basically, she was perfect. Not that she was like a robot or something. Robots are not even perfect. But she was the student that everyone else wanted to be. Lizette was bright, easygoing, and above all, had her future laid out right in front of her. Unlike the average student, she knew what she wanted to do after high school, and as a result, she was confident and ambitious, though sometimes it could rub a lot of people the wrong way. Moreover, I had known her ever since I was young, but it had ultimately resulted in a rival. Fuck! Moreover, I had known her ever since I was young, but it had ultimately resulted in a rivalry that continued today. Of course, my friends knew what was between us, and upon seeing me glance at her, they shifted their attention to her.
She doesn't even look like she's working, in my opinion.
She probably is, but she's too much of a stuck-up priss to allow herself to look like she's actually doing work.
Wow.
Oh, come on, Suzu. She may be a little off-putting, but she's not the giant priss that you're making her seem to be.
The day she isn't a priss is the day I turn into you.
Oh, shit.
What's that supposed to mean?
Never mind. It's about time. Let's bail.
Oh, that bitch is gone. Unsurprisingly, Suzu was the first out of the classroom, slinging her backpack over her shoulder with ease as she quickly strolled out the door.
Chrissy isn't even closest to the exit, and she always manages to be the first one out of the door.
Exactly.
I don't think I'll ever understand that.
Fuck. She gave me a smile as if I relit. She gave me a Fuck. It's fucking a lot of reading. She gave me a smile as if relived. Fuck! She gave me a smile as if relieved by the fact that I felt the same way she did.
See? Why can't she just be normal like the two of us?
I don't know. It's Suzu, Naomi. Think about it.
Very true.
You guys are slow. Are you coming or what?
We heard you the first time. Not everyone has rocket boosters attached to their legs when the bell rings.
Exactly.
Are you kidding me? That class was ridiculously boring. Even Miss Valedictorian here was dozing off a bit.
Aha. I do have to admit I was spacing out, and just because I answered one question doesn't mean I'm automatically the valedictorian.
Okay, so it wasn't too interesting. But you should at least pay attention when Phillips is talking about the important parts.
So you finally admit it. We're finally on the same wavelength. Welcome to the club, Patterson.
Please, don't call me by my last name. This isn't the classroom. Never in a million years will we ever see things eye to eye.
Despite this, they both burst out into laughter. Normally, anyone would think that opposites like them wouldn't ever associate with each other, but even though they were so different, their friendship somehow made a lot of sense. Maybe they were just perfect complements or personality just didn't dictate the possibility of their friendship. After all, we three had been best friends since preschool.
All right, so where are we heading to first? Cafeteria? I think we can all agree that we're really hungry, especially after hearing about our company's line of deliciously spicy bubblegum.
Who would even buy that? I wonder.
I would, even though I don't chew gum.
Me? I would pay good money to get a taste of it.
Haha, you do like spicy food after all. We entered the cafeteria, a bustling room filled with the aromas of different kinds of foods. As we got in line, we ordered our meals and chatted freely.
Cajun fries and the spicy chicken burger for me. That's my definition of a good meal.
I'll take a tuna sandwich and some juice. You're probably going to need water or something to curb all that spicy flavor, Suzu.
I can't be tamed by the likes of that. If it's spicy, then it's gotta be all or nothing.
You're crazy.
Oh, yeah, I'm crazy.
I think I'm getting a migraine.
I think I'll go with... Ew. I don't... Yeah. I forgot what Naomi's having because she's annoying. Let's do this one. That sounds good. Yeah. Once we got our food, we settled down at one of the empty tables, putting our backpacks aside to finally dig into the food. Suzu leaned back in her chair, tilting it back so that she could rest her feet on the table by her food.
All right, then. Is there anything we want to talk about?
Bored already?
I know. Let's talk about...
Say boys, and I will never speak to you ever again.
Why not?
What's so interesting about talking about guys? Not like any of us are going to get boyfriends anytime soon.
Well,
we don't know that. What if one of us does get a boyfriend?
Like, that's going to happen, Naomi. Look at us. I'm a tiny Italian. You're a ditzy blonde.
Oh, shit.
Hey!
No offense. And Anderson here. Well, I guess she could land a boyfriend or girlfriend if she wants.
Or girlfriend?
She can be a lesbian if she wants.
I can do whatever I want.
True.
That's okay, Suzu. I'm not sure I want a boyfriend yet.
Why not? It's our senior year. Might as well get a boyfriend.
No, that's okay.
Maybe she's just not interested in a relationship, Suzu.
Well, it really wasn't about wanting a relationship, but more of there was no one interesting enough to be in a relationship with. Don't get me wrong, I'm an open person, but there were not many interesting guys in the school to go out with. Duh, they're high school guys. Who knows? Time will tell. Naomi looked at me, wanting to continue the conversation. However, before she could speak, the speakers in the cafe started up an announcement echoed through the cafeteria.
Miss Anderson, please come to the main office immediately. Please bring your things with you.
What the fuck did I do?
Oh my.
Looks like our plans have been cut short. The men in white coats have finally come to get you.
Suzu, don't joke around. What if it's serious?
Whatever.
Fine. If something happens, just call us.
Okay. Funny enough, something did happen. And it was certainly no laughing matter. Cold, it was really cold. The rain became heavier that afternoon, accompanied by rolling thunder now and then. The skies had turned dark, though I couldn't see any of it under the black umbrella. Not that I was looking up. In fact, looking up was the exact opposite of what I wanted to do. I stared at the grass beneath my feet, unable to look up at the people weeping around me. All I could see was the damp grass under my feet. Only the monotone eulogies that floated through my ears reminded me that I was at a funeral. What the fuck? Who died? Granddad? It was only when the speeches ended that I finally was able to raise my head. Harold Anderson, forever in our hearts, okay? A small gathering of people, mostly made of relatives that I didn't even know were related to me, were huddled around a simple small grave. For a while, all I heard was the sound of raindrops on umbrellas. If it weren't raining, everything would probably be in a heavy silence. I looked beside me where my father was standing and holding up a large black umbrella for our small family of three. His face was emotionless, a strange sight next to my weeping mother. I wondered what was going through his mind. I think it's a granddad. After all, etched into the smooth gray tombstone before us was his father's name. Yep. My grandfather, the one who raised me like his own daughter, had passed away that day. Wait a minute. The ceremony was small, only close family were allowed to come. So, he died. And they had the funeral the same fucking day? What the fuck is that? They were prepared. Somebody took him out. He ain't die on his own. Mm-mm. Slowly, though, people began to leave, leaving my father, mother, and me behind at the grave. A man dressed in a clean black suit under the uniform black umbrella of the funeral attendees walked towards us, introducing himself as grandfather's lawyer. Okay. He pulled out a few documents from his suitcase and began to read aloud its contents. Can we do that not in the rain? I mean, damn.
And now, I shall read Harold Anderson's last will and testament.
Only my parents and I were allowed to be present for my grandfather's will. It was under the strict request of his lawyer. And there was a reason why.
Oh, shit. And to my dearest granddaughter, I give my estate. All the furniture and decor that resides within the house shall also be given to my granddaughter.
Oh, shit! We about to have a party, y'all! Fuck! What? Yeah, bitch, I'm rich now. I couldn't believe my ears. I had earned the family estate at 18. That was impossible, and yet it was written by my own grandfather's hand.
He passed the family estate to her? Why am I not surprised?
Durr.
Dear.
Well, did he say anything about what will become of the CEO and chairman position of the Anderson Toys Company?
No. It is presumed that the vice chairman will succeed the position.
Even to the bitter end, he wouldn't give in. What a stubborn old man.
Well, shit, look at you. You look stubborn as fuck also. Got your arms crossed, scowl on your face, and I'm looking like, I'm rich, bitch. What? No, that's a lot of upkeep. Ugh, a lot of taxes. Fuck. Shaking his head, my father turned to face my mother with a serious expression on his face.
About the estate. Should we send her there to get used to the building? It'll be a good place for her to live after high school.
Are you sure we should?
Why not? This would be a good experience for her.
Honey, what do you think?
Shit, I'm about to go buck wild up in this bitch. That's what I'm about to do. Shit. I really wasn't sure what to say. Why did my grandfather think that I was the appropriate heir to the mansion? Was I even ready to live on my own? Ain't no time like the present. Mm.
Well, that seems to be it. We'll be taking our leave now. I'm sure the little heiress needs some time to adjust.
Fuck. My dad's a fucking jerk. Get the fuck out of here, Dad.
David!
Exactly. He's a jerk. Even though she raised her voice, my dad wordlessly began walking back to the car, disinterested. He's an asshole.
Don't mind him, honey. I think that your grandfather's passing really affected him. Why don't we get back home for now?
No, he thought he was entitled. He thought he was gonna get everything. And granddad said, fuck you, bitch. You can go on ahead to the car, Mom. I think I need some time alone with Grandpa.
Oh, of course. Take all the time you need.
She gave me a quick hug and hurried after my dad. I looked around the funeral grounds, which was completely empty, save for the sullen-looking grave that was laid in front of me. I'm sure that if Grandpa were in charge of arranging all of this, it would have been much different. It was blatantly obvious that my dad was in charge of the whole event. Who else would bury their own family? Exactly, that's what I was saying! Who else would bury their own family the same day they pass away? Exactly! Like, what the fuck? Are you serious? Everyone knew my grandfather's love for toys, and yet the grave was a mere stone slab on the ground, void of any children's toys. My dad didn't even bother putting flowers. His disdain for my grandfather was almost pitiful.
Uh-huh.
Sorry, Grandpa. I tried to force out some words, but the only thing that came out was a choked sob. You told me to stay strong, but right now I'm the farthest from it. Like that one time a long time ago? Grandpa!
Oh, it's so good to see you again, sweetie.
I was swept into a giant bear hug, and we both laughed as he swung me around like an airplane. It was one of my favorite things about seeing my grandfather, the way he greeted me. Unlike my grandfather was loving and playful even as I grew older. Fuck, so her dad was a jerk the whole time. Sorry that Daddy couldn't be here today. He said that he wasn't feeling too good again. It had always been like that. Dad missed every visit to Grandpa's house, citing that he was busy with work or wasn't feeling well.
Is that so? Well, that's okay. Daddy can come around next time. And you're here, right?
Yeah, bitch, don't you see me? Yeah. So what are we doing today, Grandpa? Mommy says that there is a new dessert cafe open in town. Maybe we can go?
Oh, I would love to. But I've been so busy with the company these days. We're actually working on a little something. Would you like to see?
Yeah. Okay, yes. Ooh, is that a toy?
It is. I was designing a new line of them. But I feel like something's missing. You don't think you could help me out, could you?
Maybe? Of course, okay. He placed the toy in my hands with a smile, and I inspected it carefully. It was beautifully crafted, and obviously a lot of work was put into it. There was one thing, though.
So, what do you think?
I think the heart on its chest should light up when you hug it. It'll be like it's alive, and it can be like a little nightlight before you sleep. He stroked his chin, considering my input while nodding his head. After a few moments of silent deliberation, he turned to me with a chuckle.
That's a great idea! I'll get to changing it right away. You're always like my little lucky charm, dear. You always know what to add to make the perfect toy.
Don't they already have that toy? I think I've seen that. It's like a little worm. A light bug worm or some shit? I don't know. Aha, well, I hope I can be like you one day, Grandpa.
You want to make toys as well?
Well, making people happy is the best feeling in the world. I don't know if I want to make toys when I grow up, though.
You...
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. I skipped something. I'm sorry, y'all. Well, maybe making people happy is the best feeling in the world. I don't know if I want to make... Okay, I didn't miss anything.
Don't worry too much about it. You have plenty of time to decide. Besides, you should do what makes you happy as well.
Okay. That makes sense. Daddy doesn't think of it in the same way, though.
Your father. I'm sure he just wants the best for you.
No, my father's a fucking dick. That's what. Fuck. I'm not so sure about that. Mm-mm.
Sweetie, look at me.
He bent down to look at me eye level with a serious look on his face.
As much as your father may say something that doesn't make sense now, you must remember that he's always thinking about you. He loves you. There's no doubt about that. And you need to love him just as equally.
Okay. I don't hate Daddy. I really do love him. I don't know why he's like this, though.
Your father and I have had some difficulties with each other in the past. But it's nothing that you should be concerned about.
I had heard tidbits of this from my mother and various other people. The only people who had stayed quiet were my father and grandfather. Both of them refrained from saying a word on the subject matter, but it was clear that that whatever happened set up a wall between them. It's hard, though, trying to pretend as if nothing were wrong.
However, no matter what, you have to stay strong. You're a big girl already, and, well, there'll come a day when it seems like it's you against the world. But always remember that your family and friends will be here with you. Daddy, Mommy, your friends at school, me. We'll stand together to get through it.
How can you be so sure of that?
Because we'll be right here.
He pointed his finger to my head first and then pointed at my chest.
So stay strong, promise?
For a moment, he looked almost sad, pleading. But as quickly as it had come, the expression disappeared from his face, and he was all smiles once again. Promise. Upon hearing that, Grandpa let out a great burst of laughter and stood up.
All right then, enough of that. How about I whip up some special homemade dessert? I know I can't accompany you at that new cafe, but we sure can talk and eat while I cook and do some paperwork.
Okay. Homemade dessert? I'll race you to the kitchen.
Hey, slow down there. I'm not what I used to be.
Okay, you willed me the very home I love to see you in. Why? Why would you think I would be ready to take it? Especially after this? A surge of anger bubbled within me, but I quickly swallowed it. There was no use in getting mad, especially when the person in question was no longer there. Durr. I'm sorry, it's hard to stay calm when you've left me with so many questions, especially about what happened between you and Dad. Huh, what am I doing? Talking to a grave. Yeah, bitch, going crazy. My vision blurred, and I suddenly realized that I was crying. My face heated up as tears rolled down my cheeks. I'll bring you some flowers later. I miss you, Grandpa. I'll try my best to fulfill my promise I gave to you, even if the world might be turned against me. I left the grave, wiping my tears hastily so my parents wouldn't see.
Well, it's time to head back home. Okay. I'll cook up your favorite lasagna when we get home, okay?
Okay. Thanks, Mom! However, my dad didn't speak the entire drive home. I wanted to talk to him, but after his moment at the funeral, I wasn't sure if it was a good idea.
It's about time we took off those dreary black clothes.
Gathering my courage, I decided then that it was time to talk. Dad, could I ask you something?
Go ahead.
Fuck. Why do you want me to move into the estate so soon?
I thought I made that rather clear. The college near your grandfather's house is well known for its business program. You are planning to major in business, yes?
How did he know?
Right after you graduate from high school, you'll just live there and can easily commute to and from school. It's a perfect fit for you.
Okay. But it's so sudden. You just decided so quickly right after the funeral.
Don't be so sensitive. If you're like that in the real world, you'll be crushed.
Fuck. I'm just saying that maybe we could talk a bit more about my future. In reply, my father rubbed his temples and sighed quietly.
After you graduate from college, you'll work at Anderson Family Toys. I have connections since I am part of the board of directors, so you will be guaranteed a spot. That is what we talked about before, yes?
Fuck, he just barks out orders and shit. But what if...
Stop mumbling!
But what if I don't want to work there?
Don't be silly. It's the family company. Our company. I'm not just going to hand it over to some incompetent vice chairman.
Oh fuck, what if I just hand it to your ass? Here, you take it. He came closer to me and his face softened.
Look, this is all for the best, okay? You may not know it right now, but you will appreciate it later.
No, you can have it. For some reason, when I heard him say that, something snapped in me. Oh shit. I wasn't exactly sure what it was, but it made me feel so angry. Do you even care that grandfather passed away?
Of course I do.
Well, everything seems fine and dandy to you. Things couldn't be better.
Excuse me? I don't like your tone, young lady.
Bitch, I'm 18. Fuck you. It's not like nothing ever happened at all. Like you were just ignored. Hold on. I gotta get into this. It's like nothing even happened at all. Like you just ignored the fact that he's no longer here.
Do not raise your voice at me.
Motherfucker, I'ma say what I wanna say. What did he ever do to you to deserve this? My father, his face hardened, crossed his arms and erupted in angry laughter.
Ha! You sure place him upon a pedestal, like he's some kind of venerated god or something. It makes me sick.
Is that it? Are you happy seeing grandfather dead? While everyone was grieving, were you holding yourself back from laughing in everyone's faces? Did you feel just a bit happier seeing him lie in the graveyard? Oh shit. A flash of rage crossed his face and he whipped the back of his hand across my cheek. Oh, bitch, it's about to go down in this bitch. I'm turning this motherfucker out.
You don't know anything. Running your mouth like somehow you know everything that went on when you're just a little girl that doesn't know how to keep her mouth shut. You did not know my father. You did not know what he was capable of.
Oh shit.
Is everything all right? What happened?
That bitch slapped me! Nothing. Ugh. Did she really just say nothing? Oh, fuck that shit. I would have been like, I'm out this bitch! Peace! Okay, nothing. I'm not hungry. I think I'll just go upstairs.
Honey, wait!
I quickly turned and ran up the stairs to my room, slamming the door behind me. My breath came in short... My breath came in short pants, and for a while I just leaned against the door to my bedroom, eventually sliding down to sit against it. How did things become like this? My cheeks still throbbed, and I tentatively stood up and looked at the mirror to see how it looked. Hopefully it doesn't bruise. Ha! What am I saying? Tears formed in the corners of my eyes, but I blinked them back rapidly. I couldn't cry for the second time today. I had to be stronger than that.
Are you all right? Your father told me nothing happened, but you know your father.
I'm fine. I just lost my appetite.
The lasagna's done, though. And I don't want you skipping any meals. Are you sure?
Slide that shit under the door. Fuck. Oh, fuck. She says, yeah, don't worry about me, Mom. I'll come downstairs later to eat. No, the fuck I'm not. Get the fuck away from the door. I just don't want to eat right now. Get the fuck away from the door, Mom!
Please, dear. Tell me what's going on. I wish you would tell me why you're being like this.
Bitch! What did I just say? Fuck. I gotta get out now. I wanted to tell her. A part of me was screaming to tell her what Dad had done. At the same time, I knew she couldn't fix anything. Besides, I was moving out regardless. Mom is like a pushover. I remained silent, letting the event remain in the past. Why can't you, like, put in a container and put in the fridge and I'll just heat it up in the microwave or the toaster oven? What the fuck, Mom? Finally, my mom left me alone. It was strange to think that she was only a few inches away from me, only separated by a single wooden door. I really didn't know what to do. I needed to do something, anything, to get my mind off of what just happened. Anything would be better than thinking any more about the pain still radiating from my cheek. I was going to move into my grandfather's house tomorrow. I should probably pack my stuff so I would be prepared for tomorrow. Yeah, that was a good idea. I should start packing. I opened the closet, rummaging around for a while before I finally found two large bags. Pulling them out onto the floor of my room, I then began to empty my drawers and cabinets so that I could bring all of my things with me. I didn't have much to bring other than just clothes and some toiletries. It was kind of bizarre that I didn't have so many personal belongings. It wasn't like my luggage was completely devoid of them, but I certainly didn't have many things in my room that I would miss if I just suddenly left the house. I shook my head to rid myself of those thoughts. If it were going to be my new home, it would have to feel like it, one way or another. I was going to make it home. Make it a home. Oh shit. Just as I was packing my things, my cell phone began ringing and vibrating in my pocket. I slid my phone out of my pocket and answered it while slowly easing myself onto my bed. Who could possibly be calling? Either Suzu or Naomi?
Hey, Anderson, you there?
Mm-hmm. Told you.
Is everything all right? We were worried about you, so we decided to call.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Hello?
Bitch, I'm here. I'm really glad you guys called. My voice managed to come out, though it was only a whisper.
What happened? Are you okay?
Well, I slowly began to tell them about the funeral that afternoon. A small silence followed when I was done recounting what happened, and to my relief, Naomi finally spoke up.
I can't begin to imagine how you must be feeling right now. I'm so sorry. Do you want us to come over right now?
No, it's okay. My dad isn't in a good mood, so we could just keep talking on the phone like this. Oh. My dad isn't in a good mood, so could we just keep talking on the phone like this?
Of course! We'd stay on the phone until the crack of dawn, right, Suzu?
Yeah. We're always here if you need us. After all, we wouldn't be the awesome triple threat trio without you, right?
Ah ha ha ha, yeah.
Triple threat trio? That sounds like the name of a gang. Yeah, I mean, we're all taking on the world together. We've got to sound somewhat scary, or else no one's going to take us seriously.
Yep.
What's with you in naming things? You've got to step up your game, Naomi.
Mm-hmm.
Pulling behind to the cool kids like Anderson and me. Hey! I'm a cool kid! If anything, I'd say you have to step up your game!
Only a nerd would say that. We chatted cheerfully about all sorts of things. Very soon, I had forgotten about the events that day and was engaged in a conversation about Naomi's favorite TV show, some program called Herlock. We all agreed that the actor playing the titular character certainly had a very distinctive look about him, with that long overcoat and scarf wrapped around his neck. Okay. We had many disagreements about who we thought was the coolest character. Aha! Yeah, he was really high... Yeah, he has really high cheekbones, and his eyes are pretty, though I don't have... Though I do have to say I prefer Jatson. And as a bonus, his actor is just so sassy. I looked at the clock hanging on the wall and realized how late it was. Whoa, it's already 1 a.m.? Sorry for keeping you guys up so late. I think I'm gonna hit the hay for tonight. See you guys at school tomorrow. I should probably shower and go to bed. I can't believe I stayed up this late just to talk to my friends. But it was really nice. Well, to the bathroom I go. I took a relaxing shower. Nothing beat hot water and the feeling of being clean. After drying myself, I promptly dressed in my pajamas and crawled into bed. A nice hot shower after a long day. I'm so glad to finally be in bed. It had been a really long day. I knew that I was wishing for something to change back in class, but I certainly wasn't expecting any of the things that happened today. And I have to go back to school tomorrow. Ugh. I curled up on my side and tightly wrapped the blankets around me. I really wasn't in the mood to be returning to the school, but my dad probably would make me go just for the sake of it. It's time to go to sleep. I reached out to the lamp on my nightstand to turn off the lights. However, my mind was so lost in the passing of my grandfather and the thought of inheriting something so big that it haunted my mind the entire night until the next morning. Fuck. I shook my head to try to clear the sleepiness out of me to no avail. I really didn't get any sleep last night. It's already time to wake up? Wait, school. As soon as I realized I had to go to school, I slid out of bed and looked at the vanity mirror. That's a relief. Luckily, there was barely a bruise on my cheek. You had to squint to actually see it. I doubt anyone would actually notice it unless they leaned in really close. Fuck Suzu, nosy ass. Breathing out a sigh, I got dressed, took my backpack, and caught the bus to go to school. It wasn't even hours before everyone heard of the news. I was approached in school and given condolences for my loss. However, that wasn't what shocked my friends.
Wait, so you have the whole Anderson house to yourself? Lucky as hell, man!
I can't let Suzu come over. She's gonna turn that shit out. Fuck, and Naomi's gonna be over there watching everybody.
Quit being so sensitive, Naomi. Quit being so vulgar, Suzu!
Fuck it. Suzu, I'm with Suzu! Naomi's a fucking negative Nancy, man.
Of course you would side with her!
Yeah, bitch!
Huh! See? At least she knows how to have fun.
Yep.
I know how to have fun! You don't need to be wild to have fun!
I don't know why he's gonna sit around doing Scrabble. Fuck. Guys, I'm going there right... Hold on. Guys, I'm going there after school today because my parents want me to get used to living there.
Seriously? It hasn't even been a day since you came back to school.
I know. I'm sorry. But my dad's an asshole. I know, but my parents want me to try living there as soon as possible.
Still, that's really fast. Are you going to be okay?
Fuck yeah. Shit. Of course. Ha ha. But even in the comfort of my best friends... Life seemed to be keep testing me. What the fuck?
Hey! Don't go around shoving people like that!
Aw, shit.
Whoops.
What the fuck is that?
Nerve, Capini.
Lizette? Lizette looked like fucking Larry. What the fuck? That big... She is a... I mean, she's not fat, but she's a big bitch. She let out a small laugh as she twirled her hair around her fingers. Lizette, one of the last people I wanted to see today. Fuck.
It's not me you should be apologizing to. Oh, Anderson. Hey, how's it going?
Bitch, I'm all right.
Haven't you already heard, Lizette? Of what? Her grandfather's passing.
Well, I'm sorry about that. I don't really watch a lot of news.
It doesn't really sound like you mean it.
I do mean it. Earnestly. Why wouldn't I?
Typical Capini. Isn't her family involved with the Mafia or something? I wouldn't be surprised if she brought out a bat from behind her back right this moment.
Oh gosh. I had nearly forgotten the crowd that followed Lizette, which was mostly comprised of people that no one wanted to see on a typical school day. Oh shit. No one had the slightest idea why exactly they followed Lizette around persistently, but they labeled themselves as social equals with her.
That is out of line! Suzu comes from an honest family!
Says the one whose family profits from political scandals.
What?
Yeah, your dad doesn't make anything unless he's in the court with dirty politicians.
What the fuck? Naomi, smack a bitch.
Hey, let's all calm down for a second, alright? I'm sure Anderson needs some time to recuperate. I mean, what just happened? We need to give her some respect.
Yeah, bitch. Give me some fucking respect. Just stop. Stop acting like that already. Like you feel sorry for me.
Hmm? What are you talking about?
Bitch, you don't even fucking like me! Hold on, let me see what she says. Okay, I'm sure you're happy seeing me like this. You already have everything you wanted, and now seeing me like this, life couldn't get any better. Bitterness seeped into me, and words started flying out of my mouth without filter. Aw, shit, sounds like me! But honestly, I didn't care. I was so consumed by anger that I only saw Lizette in front of me. What exactly am I to you? Just another part of your obstacle course? Is that what I am? I'm sick of it, Lizette. I'm sick of all these charades. I'm sick of you. Gasps rose from the crowd around her, and I was brought back to the school hallway. Even my friends beside me looked at me in surprise. Not my friends. That would be expected of me in high school. One girl looked like she was going to speak up, but Lizette held her hand up to stop her. There was an emotion in her face that I couldn't quite make out, but I could see a form of pity in her eyes. No, don't you dare pity me, bitch. I looked away from her. I didn't want to see that emotion in her eyes when she was talking to me. She didn't have the right to look at me that way.
I'm sorry. I know your grandfather passing away must have really taken a toll on your emotions.
Can we just smack a bitch right now? She stepped towards me and put her hand on my... This bitch put her hands on me? She put them paws on me? Oh, it's going down in this fucking school. Okay, she stepped towards me and put her hand on my shoulder, giving me a tiny smile as if for old time's sakes. Can we fucking punch the bitch? Well, but for some reason, I didn't feel comforted at all. Not that I was just angry at her, but the expression on her face when she leaned in close to me contorted into something complex. Something was different about her. I couldn't quite place my finger on it, but something about her had definitely changed.
Well, I'll be going for now. Track meet responsibilities and all of that stuff. See you later.
Something about Lizette made me feel uncomfortable. I wasn't just angry, but also uneasy. What was it? I had never seen her like that before. But I decided to pay no further attention to it. She continued running down the hall with her gaggle of friends behind her. I refocused my attention to Miss Phillips, who was walking down the hall towards me.
Is everything all right, girls?
Nothing we couldn't handle, Mrs. P. Just a bunch of snobs.
Mm-hmm.
Suzu, hush! It was nothing, Mrs. Phillips.
I see. Well, Miss Anderson, please accept my condolences for your loss.
Okay. Thank you, Miss Phillips.
Your grandfather was a good man. He really upheld the philanthropy of his company's policies, and the money that went towards charity, too.
I know. He was amazing. I really looked up to him and want to be as good as he was.
Well, I know that you'll be as great as your grandfather.
Hell yeah, she will. She'll be 10 times better than her grandfather.
Would I? Would I really be better than my grandfather? Everyone seemed to have high expectations for me. I wanted to do my best and make my family proud, but to be better than my grandfather? I wasn't sure about that. From outside the school window, I saw a familiar blue car pull up to the curb. Undoubtedly, it was my father in the driver's seat. Oh, my ride's here. Well, I guess I'll see you both tomorrow.
Want us to come with you?
I would say yeah, but fuck, the screen says no. Oh no, it's okay, haha, I'll be fine, see you. Fucking liar. Hey, bitch.
Hey, honey.
As I got into the car, I noticed my father looked troubled, clutching at his steering wheel and staring straight ahead, as if something was really bothering him. Something bothers this asswipe? Okay, let's go.
About what happened yesterday. I'm sorry for yelling at you. Does your cheek still hurt?
Yeah, bitch! We should punch him right now. No, I'm gonna punch him. No, it's nothing to worry about. Lies.
I mean it. I shouldn't have laid a finger on you. You know that you're my most precious daughter. You're all that I have.
Uh-huh.
I...
What the fuck do you want, Dad? Yet he couldn't bring himself to say what he could never say to me for such a long time. I always wanted to hear those words to affirm how he really felt, but I guess even now he couldn't say it to me. I turned my head away to look out the window. There was no point in waiting for something that was never going to come. And like that, he started to drive and the conversation between us ended. I decided to focus my attention on the passing scenery. We were taking the usual route to Grandfather's house. It was located within the vicinity of the school district, but it was still pretty far from the school and from where our house was. He had always lived alone. He insisted on doing things by himself, even at his age living in such a large house. I wondered, did he pass away with no one at his side as well? It sounded so lonely and sad. It was strange that he decided on living all alone in his large estate. If anything, he could have lived with us. Though he and my father probably would have given each other the silent treatment the entire time, maybe living alone was preferable to that. I actually hadn't visited him for quite a while. Visits to his house were most frequent when I was a child, and I had grown up long since then. The last time I visited, though, I thought he looked just as he usually was, happy and healthy. But things change. In the back of my mind, I knew that he would have to leave one day. It wasn't like humans could live forever. So, why did my heart still feel so heavy? The car ride was mostly spent in silence until he spoke up again.
How was school? Maintaining your grades, I hope.
Fuck you. Yeah, I've been trying my best as of so far.
Trying? That's not really doing the best you can, is it?
Oh, this motherfucker. With my father, only some words I said were filtered through his ears. It was difficult to keep up a conversation without eventually talking about it, academics or my future, even if it was something loosely based on it. He always found a way to integrate it whenever we talked.
Anyway, your belongings are in the trunk. There isn't a lot, so I'm sure you can manage bringing them inside the house. After all, you are on the road to being independent now.
Really, bitch? You couldn't walk my shit in the house for me? What the fuck is a dick? Yes, I can manage on my own, you fucker. The usual silence resumed between us. I really wasn't sure what to say around him, especially when most of the time we didn't share the same opinions. One question did linger in my mind, though. If he was going to justify acting so nonchalant at Grandfather's funeral, I had the right to at least know why. Oh, I'm gonna try it again. Oh, we gonna revisit this right now. Say, Dad, about you and Grandpa...
We are not talking about this.
I feel like we should be, because Grandpa did leave us yesterday, so...
I wouldn't care if he had left even long before that. I do not want to hear it, and that is the end of this conversation.
Are you fucking kidding me? Bitch, I'm not working at no damn toy company then. As always, he managed to shut down any other form of conversation related to him. It was just like what happened last night. I opened my mouth slightly, but closed it again. It was like talking to a brick wall. It wasn't like I could find out anything by somehow arguing my way through it. All right then. I leaned against the car door and stared out the window. I really couldn't think. What would this place be like? I had been to my grandfather's house before, but it was one thing visiting and another thing actually living there. How would I manage living on my own without any training to really care for a house? I knew that naturally the bills would be paid by my parents who inherited grandfather's stocks to the corporation, but I never lived independently before. Thinking about it made me feel some kind of bird being pushed out of the nest. Though I was technically an adult, I felt unprepared and a bit daunted at the prospect of actually moving into a new place. Most people my age would be ecstatic moving out. After all, it would symbolize some kind of change in their lives, like being on the road to independence. But I felt like it was nothing of the sort. I really hoped I wouldn't let my parents down. I wouldn't want to let Grandfather down. What would he be saying right now? I gazed up at the passing clouds in the skies. Wait. I gazed up at the passing clouds in the sky. If you're out there, Grandfather, how would you be doing? How you doing? Would you be anything you'd want to tell me at this? Wait. Would there be anything you'd want to tell me at this moment? And of course, no answer. What was I doing, searching for an answer in a heaven that would or would not exist? I ducked my head to stare at the blur of the trees and cars up from the car window. My head was definitely going into the clouds there at the moment. Either way, I found myself being driven off to my new home. Woo! Look at that! Okay, the car rolled to a stop and I drifted out of my thoughts.
Here we are. Go on in.
Bye, bitch. Alright, tell Mom I love her.
Alright.
Do I have to say that? Because he's a fucking dick. I love you, Dad. Yeah. Didn't think so. No, make sure to come by. make sure to come by and visit us often. No, I'm going to miss you lots. Nothing other than a blank stare. I paused a bit before reaching for the car door handle, waiting for any form of goodbye, but he didn't speak again. I sighed and exited the car. Hearing my dad pop open the trunk, I saw the two large bags I packed last night that were large enough to carry only the things I needed. I took them out, placed one bag on each shoulder, and closed the trunk. He then drove off, leaving me alone in the front of the mansion. I watched the blue car fade into the distance off the road before turning to see my new home. So he couldn't even walk me into the house to make sure the killer wasn't in there waiting for me before he left? This fucking asswipe. There it is. It's huge. My grandfather gave me this. It's hard to believe. The house was framed by a set of tall gates, and I hesitantly pushed them aside to take in the entire estate. The house still looked like it was when I last visited him. At a glance, it seemed kind of intimidating with its size, though if I came closer, it was clear that there were more to it than that. The brick walls were framed by shrubbery and lovely flowers, giving it a homey and welcoming look. But in contrast, the tall doors into the house gave me a feeling of grandeur. Who knew what was waiting for me? But I wouldn't back down at this moment. I took out the key to the front doors and unlocked them. Well, might as well make myself at home. I'll be staying here for quite a while anyways. That's when I saw them. Lying on the floor was a group... Now hold up, wait a minute. Lying on the floor was a group of men. They were all unconscious, but there was no explanation as to why they were there in the first place. I dropped my bags as I let the door close on its own behind me. Huh? Who the heck are these guys? Why are they here and what's going on? Some of them had open wounds. Wounds? What the fuck? Who's gonna clean that shit up? The blood was staining the floor and the scent was intermingling with the air. What the fuck is this shit? I couldn't help but feel bad for them instinctively, but nevertheless, I was shocked and a bit angry at the sudden intrusion. My mind suddenly went from caring and concerned to confused and demanding answers. Who are you guys? No response. I'll call the police. Still nothing. None of them seemed to be awake to answer or respond to me. It seemed surreal to have random strangers in the house I just moved into. But I wanted answers quickly, That was until... Yeep! Yeep? Bitch, karate chop his ass! Get away from me!
Woman, you're going to let me kiss you.
What? Are you, wait, hold? This bitch trying to get his ass whooped today. I'm not the one. I couldn't believe it myself, but within a mere blink of an eye, one of the men went from lying on the floor to being right in front of my face. What was even more odd was the fact that I felt serene and calm about it. Bitch, you just as crazy as him. Slowly, a desire burned from my chest, telling me to accept his kiss, even when my mind vehemently... Slowly, a desire burned from my chest, telling me to accept his kiss, even when my mind vehemently refused. Go ahead.
Good.
What the fuck? What the fuck? As he kissed me, I could feel my body go weak. I didn't know why, but that kiss was draining me of my energy, and yet it was so good and made my heart sing. It was a strange and tingly feeling that danced over every nerve on my body. I could feel streams of intangible energy run up my body into my lips. It felt odd, but at the same time, it felt amazing.
Sam, stop it.
The person kissing me, Sam was his name, glanced behind him.
I said stop. Now.
Fine.
What the fuck? Finally, he pulled back and I was left standing there in a daze. What? Huh? Bitch, why are you kissing strangers? What the fuck is wrong with you? I couldn't tell what was going on. My mind was completely enwrapped by the kiss in my thoughts that melted into the depths of my forgotten memories.
Please forgive my brother. He's a bit reckless.
At least I feel a hell of a lot better than you right now.
Oh my gosh.
Because you used your abilities on her.
Abilities?
Sam, you're such a reckless brute. Taking advantage of a beautiful young woman like her.
What?
Shut that pretty boy mouth of yours before I rip it off your pretty boy face.
Oh shit. What the?
Jeez, you guys. Can we not fight right now? Not all of us are in the best state.
How many guys are in here?
I guess you are right, Matthew. I agree.
What? Another one? However, as the men got up and started to chat freely, my thoughts began to reassemble and I remembered my confusion and anger once again, only multiplied tenfold. What? What?
Huh? Did you say something beautiful?
Oh, fuck. And I exploded. What is... I'm not gonna yell. What is going on? Why the hell are you all here in my house? Why are you all wounded? Why did you kiss me? Who are you guys? I couldn't help exploding, but after being taken advantage of and being left in a mush state, my words escaped without filter. I definitely scared the men around me, even the man who kissed me. Wait a second, the guy who kissed me?
Ouch! What's your problem?
She punched and slapped him. Good. What's your problem? You can't just go around forcing people to kiss you like that. Are you some kind of pervert?
Pervert? It was only a kiss.
Bitch, please. It might mean nothing to you, but it means a lot to me.
What? Was it your first kiss?
Oh, shit.
Ow! Hey, what was that for?
She smacked him again. I know first kisses aren't exactly amazing and full of sparkles and something out of a fairy tale, but I had at least expected it to be more than just something forced.
So it was your first kiss. Stop making such a big deal out of it.
Oh, shit. Are you asking to get punched again? Oh, she punched his ass. Good for you.
Well, what do you want me to do? It's not like I can somehow take it back.
That is true. I'm gonna hit his ass again just because.
Ow! You're just being violent now!
Yeah, I am. You deserved it, bitch. Anyway, if you try to pull any funny business in the future, just a fair warning, I know Taekwondo. I think I've bickered enough. Time to get back to the main issue. So, what exactly are all of you doing in my house? I think this is a good time to end the gameplay here. Now, it took a moment to get here, because obviously it's a visual novel, and they got to build the suspense. So now it's getting real juicy. Give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw or heard. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. If you want to see more of this gameplay, give this video a thumbs up, and if it gets, let's say, 20 likes, I'll do another gameplay of this on a future Anime Wednesday, and I will see you guys next time. Oh, and don't forget to follow me on Twitch. The handle is the same as here, at GuiltSummer5196. I have started streaming this week, usually around 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!